Welcome back to Sputnik. White police officers shooting or choking to death unarmed black men is hardly a new thing in the land of the free. Grand juries garlanding the perpetrators, who then become the darlings of the talk shows and the tea parties, is rather more disturbing, seeming to indicate that justice is breaking down for black America and under the country's first black president. On board the Sputnik today is the undisputed champion of the fight for justice, not just for people of color, but for the poor and downtrodden everywhere. My old friend Lee Jasper. Lee, welcome to the show. Choking to death a black man unarmed for selling cigarettes on the street in New York City, not in the deep South. The grand jury says the officer who choked him to death is not to be prosecuted, but the man who filmed it all is being prosecuted. Am I right? Is this actually beginning now to break down visibly in front of our eyes?
Well, it makes the assumption that justice was built up for African Americans. The reality is there's 2 million African Americans in lockdown as we speak in American jails. And they're there for all sorts of spurious charges, fake accusations, and really victims of systemic and cultural institutionalized racism in the American justice system. And of course, George, you've got to remember, Tamir Rice was shot. He was 12 years old.
12 years old, and he was on the playground, I understand.
He was on the playground. He's dead. He now lies on a mortuary slab. We have the case of the young man who was running with his daughter to get an asthma pump because she was having an asthma attack. Shot dead. We have the case of Mike Brown, whom we all know in Ferguson. Shot dead. There is a killing spree going on in America, and black men's lives do matter, but they're currently endangered by the criminal justice system.
And this is happening under Barack Obama. Has he got anything to say about it? And Eric Holder, by the way, who's also a black attorney general.
I think that, you know, if you think that replacing a black face in a high place solves your problems of tackling racism, then you're guilty of the worst type of naivety and tokenism. What you need is a systemic change in order to tackle institutionalized racism. It's not capable of being changed by force of personality, such as endemic strength. And Barack Obama has already showed his true neoliberal colors on international affairs. Poverty has increased for African Americans. Unemployment has increased. And all over the world, where the austerity agenda is writ large, we see it acting as a magnifying glass on racism and institutionalized racism, both in America, here in UK, and in wider Europe.
Well, the American case is not that surprising, and you've just corrected me. My question assumed a level of justice for African Americans that didn't actually exist. I just had the feeling in Ferguson and so on, when the kind of militarized police response just seemed to me a qualitative step change. But I may be wrong about that. But in Britain, and indeed in Europe, the same thing is happening.
Well, we all saw the tragic video recently of Eric Garner, whose tragic last words, "I can't breathe, I can't breathe," now have been taken up, as long with "hands up, don't shoot," as the sort of master cry.
The last words.
Absolutely, for black justice in America and for justice universally. And here in the United Kingdom, we have our own Eric Garner video. It's been out for a number of years. It's Christopher Adler, the paratrooper, the British paratrooper who came back from Hull, who's filmed and on video, lying naked on a floor with his hands tied behind his back, his pants down behind his knees, and choking to death on his own vomit while officers stand around giggling and laughing at him. These are real cases that you can see now. Janet Adler is his sister, been campaigning for justice. We have Kingsley Burrell from Birmingham, phoned the police because he was threatened by a gang who were waiting for him and his son outside a shop. The police arrived 3 days later with their head the size of a melon. Kingsley Burrell writes a note to his sister saying, "They're trying to kill me," after he's committed to a mental institution. 24 hours later, he died. Alton Manning, Smiley Culture, Mark Duggan, Sean Rigg, another gruesome case of caught on video of a young man dying in Brixton police station in the reception area. It goes wider afield than that. If we look at southern Europe, we see Africans being lynched, shot and murdered in southern Italy by neo-fascist groups in addition to what's happening in Greece. So austerity is ramping up racism worldwide, and neoliberal sentiment is to continue to push that, to divert people's attention away from the real authors of the economic destruction, the casino investment bankers and their plutocratic mates who have destroyed the economies of the Western world and are now blaming blacks, migrants and anybody else they can.
And ironically, these people are only in Italy because of NATO wars against their own countries. And black people, Gaddafi was a shambolic leader, no doubt. Mm. But
he would champion... let's explore that. Because for the black community, if you talk about Gaddafi, you're talking about a champion. Putting aside his idiosyncratic ways, and he had many, in relation to his commitment to Africa and Southern Africa, he was the one who ensured there was no or very little discrimination against Africans from Southern Africa in North Africa. He was the champion against that sort of discrimination, and he supported the African Union with millions of petrol dollars.
And the African National Congress.
And the African National
and
Congress.
And
Thomas Sankara, and the struggle against Portuguese colonialism.
No doubt about that.
Yeah.
And that's why,
yeah,
after the overthrow of Gaddafi, the people who overthrew him began to lynch black people in Libya.
That's right.
Black people then flee on boats. They arrive in Italy and they're gunned down by the people in Italy who sunk in their own economic problems. Suddenly
Barcelona.
See all these black people arriving from Africa. And murder them.
If you go to southern Italy, and I've been, it reminds me of the, I think I'm in a 1950s, Mockingbird movie. It's reminiscent of that. The racism is naked. It's in front of your face. There's no shame about it. There's no restraint about it. In Greece, the Golden Dawn and the police have been proven to be one and the same. Off-duty officers acting as the...
Golden Dawn's the
yes.
Fascist party outfit
working with Greek police to round up African migrants into concentration camps on the outskirts of Athens. Wherever the economic crisis is acutest, racism is inversely rising in proportion to that crisis.
With fascism on its heels, not far behind. Gayatri.
I wonder whether this doesn't build up to some sort of intifada amongst black people in the US and here in Britain and Europe.
Well, of course, here in the United Kingdom, we saw in the aftermath of Mark Duggan's tragic death, where the police accused him of shooting them, and in fact, he had no weapon at all, an uprising. I think that due to austerity, economic crisis, the country at the moment, particularly in the inner city areas where poor whites, black, Irish, others live, is like a tinderbox. And the least catalytic flame will set it roaring. It's not generally known by the mainstream media or the liberal establishment.
No, not at all.
I predicted the riot of 2011 in January 2011 after the death of Smiley Culture. I said the black community was at boiling point. We're still at boiling point because no justice has been served for any. There's not a single officer been charged with the death, the murder, or even any associated crime, neglect of duty or anything, with the death of a black man in British custody, ever. And so we like the Americans.
Say that again. There's no...
Never, ever
been
a
charge
against
murder. Any prison officer, police officer, on the death of any black prisoner, anytime, anywhere.
Not in the United Kingdom, no. I'll be correct if I'm saying I don't think that's even happened in the United States. And there are 13 cases in the United Kingdom history that have been put before a jury. And even with compelling evidence, the jury always sides with the police. That's exactly what happened in the grand jury. And that's why my position has always been, you can't have all white juries making assessments of justice.
I mean, the Ferguson case was an all white jury, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was.
In an area,
New York.
Well, it is extraordinary, I must say, in Missouri. But it's more extraordinary in
New York City. Yeah.
Absolutely.
And the choking to death of this black man on camera. How could that not lead to charges?
Well,
it's actually almost, if it weren't for the fact we're talking about the death of a man, it would be laughable. It's like a joke that it's there on camera. The police officers are choking the man to death for selling cigarettes on the street. But nobody gets charged.
Except the one who's filming it.
Except the guy who films it.
Well, I mean...
he's under arrest.
You try and make sense of racism, and it'll leave you as confused, angry, and incensed as it does the black community. Because it makes no sense. Because racism, as a thought process, is a mental illness that makes no sense. And so there's no understanding the injustice that happened to Eric Gardner. And that's why you've seen the roads in New York blocked, people on the street. Next Wednesday, we're trying to organise a public meeting here, an international solidarity meeting for the victims of police brutality worldwide, in solidarity here and abroad. Racism makes no sense. It never has done. And that's why you need systemic legislation. If you have a case that involves race, you must have a multiracial jury. You must, because racism by its very nature is difficult to see for those who enjoy white privilege. And when they enjoy it, they don't see black injustice.
People should follow you on Twitter, because you're involved in all these campaigns, and that's the best way to get involved. Lee Jasper, as always, fantastic interview. Thanks very much.